The Quran refers to the lives of many prophets. One of these is Prophet Noah, peace be upon him. He, like other prophets, sought to turn his people away from their distorted beliefs and called them to the path of God. However, these people persisted in refusing to believe in him, for which reason they were destroyed with a terrible flood. The evidence of that flood has been preserved as a detriment to others for thousands of years. When the waters rose, we carried you in the ship to make it a reminder for you and something to be retained by retentive ears. Noah's tribe lived an irreligious life, far removed from God's verses. They either denied God or else ascribed partners to him. God honored Noah with prophethood and charged him with pointing this deviant tribe towards the true path. Noah countless times advised his people to have faith in God and to abide by his religion. The Quran describes how he warned his people and called them to the path of God. We sent Noah to his people, and he said, "My people, worship God. You have no deity other than him, so won't you guard against evil?" However, instead of finding the true path, they denied Noah and accused him of being possessed. In addition, they decided to watch and oppress him. In the face of these reactions, Noah always sought shelter in God and begged for his help. The ruling circle of Noah's people said, "He is nothing but a man possessed, so wait a while and see what happens to him." He said, "My Lord, help me because of their calling me a liar." Despite all this pressure from the associators, Noah continued to warn them and strove day and night to lead them to the true path. Yet his warnings failed to direct those unbelieving people to the true path. The members of his tribe refused to follow the path of God and closed their ears in great ignorance to Noah's warnings and advice. In the face of this, Noah prayed to God with great sincerity and sought his help. He called upon his Lord, "I am overwhelmed, so help me." Thank you. He said, "O my Lord, I have called to my people night and day, but my call only increases their flight from the right." God answered this prayer, which Noah uttered with such sincerity, telling him that he would afflict the associators with great suffering and punishment. That suffering was an enormous flood. God ordered Noah, who had heeded his command so scrupulously, to build a boat. Noah carefully constructed this boat. During the flood, the faithful would take shelter in this boat and be saved from the terrible suffering sent by God. The unbelievers, on the other hand, would be drowned. The punishment wreaked on those who refused to believe in Noah is described in verses of the Quran. Build the ark under our supervision, and as we reveal, and do not address me concerning the wrongdoers, they shall be drowned.